Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm looking at comparing fractions, raising a fraction to a power, and translating fractions. Greater than is the symbol that points to the right, and less than is the symbol that points to the left. And the arrow should always point at the lesser number or the number with the lesser value. Sometimes you can compare fractions just by looking at them and thinking about it a second. 2/3, I'm only missing 1/3 here. What's half of a third? Half of a third is 1.5. 2 is more than half, so this is a number that's greater than half. But this fraction is less than a half, because half of 5 would be 2.5, and we have way less than that. So I can see that 2/3 must be the greater fraction over 1/5. It's pointing to the lesser value. But also, is another way I could do that is to rewrite these with a common denominator. The common denominator would be 15, and then I would say 3 times 5 is 15, so 2 times 5 is 10, and 5 times 3 is 15, so 1 times 3 is 3, and you can see that 10/15 would be greater than 3/15, so you could look at it either way. Okay, what about these? They already have the common denominator, so all I have to do is say, well, which one's greater? I have more with 7 than I do with 4. Think about a piece of pizza with 9 pieces, and you got 7 or you got 4. I mean, obviously, this is the smaller value here. I'm going to point to that smaller value, or 4/9 is less than 7/9. What about 1/7 and 1/5? Well, when you have this 1 on the top, think about it. If you're going to share a pizza with 7 people and you get 1 piece, or share with 5 people and get a piece, which one is the bigger piece? You're going to get more if you're only sharing with 5. So I know in this case that 1/7 is smaller than 1/5. But what's the common denominator here? It'd be 35. 7 times 5 is 35. So 1 times 5 is 5. 5 times 7 is 35. So 1 times 7 is 7, and you can see that 7 is bigger than 5. Again, I could have done it that way to compare. But just using your brain is also nice without doing any calculations. But what about something hideous like number 4? I don't know which one's greater, and even to find a common denominator is a pain. So what's another way I could do that without doing either of the methods that we were just looking at? Well, another really nice method is just to cross multiply. You can always do it. But I didn't do it on the first 3 because I didn't think I needed it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply 72 times 6. And I'm going to write that answer above because that's how it's going to work for me. 432. And then I'm going to multiply 89 times 5. I'm going to write that number above. 445. And I'm going to compare these two fractions by looking at the number above it. Do you see how 445 is greater than 432? Well, that's how I know then that 5/72 is greater than 6/89. I can do this cross multiplication thing, but it works only if you write the number above or on top of it. Would it have worked up here when I had 4/9 and 7/9? 9 times 7 is 63, 4 times 7 is 36. It sure would have worked because I can see that 36 is less than 63. So it would have worked on those other ones as well. And maybe you want to try this one on your own without my help and then come back and see how you did. We could rewrite this having a common denominator, or we could use that multiplication trick. 15 times 20 is 300, and 25 times 11 is 275. So, and of course, you don't have to do that in your head or try like I did, because you can make mistakes. You can always use your calculator. But 275 is less than 300. So 11/15 is less than 20/25. I just cross multiplied and then I compared the numbers on the top. I'm always pointing that arrow to the smaller guy. Okay, this has a couple more things. This video has a couple more things. The next thing I want to talk about is, what if you have a fraction and an exponent? 1/3 to the second power looks like this, 1/3 times 1/3. It just means we're going to repeat that twice. And so 1 times 1 is always 1. That's a common mistake for people to get 2 there. Make sure you're just multiplying 1 times 1. And 3 times 3 is 9. So 1/3 to the second power is 1/9. Here's how you could do that on your calculator. Put in a fraction. So I'm going to do 1 and then the fraction third, and then I'm going to arrow out of that, get right out of that, and then I have a button that says x to the second power. Many of you will. Sometimes you have to enter that a little more manually. Ask your instructor how to use your calculator if you're not sure. So I have 1/3 squared, and that equals 1/9. So you can do that on your calculator. What about 2/3 to the third power? It looks like this, 2/3 times 2/3 times 2/3. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8, and 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. Here's another way to think about that. This also could be thought of as 2 to the third power over 3 to the third power. I'm multiplying 2 to the third power, and I'm multiplying 3 to the third power. What is 2 to the third power? Here I would use this button, third power. That's 8. That's what I got here. And then what's 3 to the third power? 3 to the third power is 27, and that's what I got there. So I could have done that on my calculator. I could do it in my head, whatever. We just want to make sure that we are multiplying those out. What about this one? Well, I can't take something to the exponent until I do what's inside the parentheses. You know that from when we were doing order of operations, and we'll do more of those. 1 plus 2 is 3. Keep the denominator the same, and then we're taking 3/5 to the second power. And that, again, could look like 3 squared over 5 squared. Well, what's 3 squared? That's 3 times 3, which is 9. What's 5 squared? 5 times 5, which is 25. And the last thing on this video is just translating. I wanted to remind you that you see things, and sometimes it just asks you to translate, not to solve. Find the quotient of, what is a quotient? A quotient is division. And whatever they state first has to go first. So this would look like 2 1/3 divided by 1 1/5. That's just the translation. We're not having you solve it, but just know what a quotient is. What about this one? Find the sum of 4/9 and 7/12. Again, we're just asking you to translate. That would be 4/9 and 7/12. What's going to go in the middle there? Sum means add. We're just asking you to write that. And what is 2/3 of 5 1/2? Well, the of is a clue about multiplication. So I could take 5 1/2 and say times 2/3. It really doesn't matter when you're adding or multiplying which one you write first, because the commutative property allows us to rearrange, but it does matter on subtraction or division. What's the word for subtraction that you know? It's difference, right? So if it asks you for a difference, then you're subtracting. Okay, have a great day.